Hi, my name is Peter Bagwell. I'm a product engineer here at Polygon Solutions Incorporated. At Polygon Solutions, we make rotary broach tools. Rotary broaches cut hexagon and square-shaped holes in metal parts, similar to the way that a drill makes a round hole in a metal part. But the question we get asked all the time is, how does it work? How does the rotary broaching tool make a square hole in a metal part? So that's the question that we're going to answer for you today. So the idea of rotary broaching has been around for about 100 years. And the concept is that instead of taking a cutting tool, which is the broach, and your part, and just punching the tool into the part to make the hole, that instead we would wobble it around a little bit at a time, corner to corner, and use the full force of the machine to just cut a little bit at a time until the broach would reach its finished depth. Now, there's a couple things that are required to make that happen. The first thing you need is a turning machine, usually a lathe, a mill, or some type of machining center. But for today's example, we're going to use a CNC lathe. So now that we have the lathe, the next thing you're going to need is the broach and the broach holder. We'll take these out of the machine and take a closer look at both of them. This is the rotary broach, which is made of high quality, high speed steel, which is very hard and is good for cutting various materials. Also, at the end of the broach, you'll notice the form is precision ground to exactly the same shape that's needed on the part. Also, this is a rotary broach made by Polygon Solutions, so you'll see that there's a vent hole or a pressure relief hole that's in the end of the broach, and that's used to relieve any hydraulic pressure that might build up during the broaching operation. Now, we can also take a closer look at the rotary broach holder. This is a GT series broach holder made by Polygon Solutions, and it includes a sealed bearing inside the holder. Now, these maintenance-free bearings are good because they never need greasing, unlike some of the older screw machine holders that require greasing every hour or so. Now, in addition to the bearings, this holder is also adjustment-free. So once it's put in the machine, there's no other adjustment needed. It's really ready to go at that point. And finally, there's a bore in the spindle at the end of the broach holder. So the broach is simply inserted into the bore, which you can see turns here with the broach, and it's locked in with a set screw. At that point, the broach holder and the broach are ready to go. So next is where the broaching takes place. And what happens is the rotary broach is going to be fed inside the pilot hole of the part. And the rotary broach itself and the spindle inside the holder are at a very slight 1 degree angle. So as it is pushed inside the part, and as the part turns inside the lathe, you can see that the broach and the spindle are going to turn together. But what happens is the broach and the spindle inside the holder are at a very slight 1 degree angle. And I'm exaggerating this quite a bit. But the reason I'm doing that is so that you can see that this bottom corner, or the closest corner to the part, is actually the part that's doing the cutting. So in the lathe, as the part is turning, and as the broach and the spindle are turning, eventually every corner at one point becomes the closest corner, and every corner gets cut a little bit at a time until the broach reaches its full depth, and then you've cut the full form in the part. Rotary broaching does have some limitations. For instance, it works best for smaller forms, usually smaller than a half inch diameter, with limited length, and it does depend on the material and other factors. In addition, you'll need some type of a turning machine, like a lathe, a mill, or some type of a machining center. However, rotary broaching is an excellent option when compared to EDM or shaping or other forms that put accurate shapes into precision machine products. Now, the GT series broach holder is the most advanced on the market today. It has sealed bearings, which eliminates the need for messy grease guns. It also has the pressure relief hole that goes through the broach and ports out the side of the broach holder to eliminate any hydraulic pressure that might build up while broaching a blind hole. And finally, it has the adjustment-free feature, where the broach is simply inserted into the holder and locked in with a set screw. Newer users are going to appreciate how easy the tool is to set up, and experienced machinists will appreciate its small size and how little room it takes up inside the machine.